Hi, I'm Charlize Theron.
Hi, I'm Danny Hernandez.
And this is Training Day with the Old Guard. I play Andy, who has been alive for many thousands of years. The character really dictated so much of what we needed to translate in the physical part.
The training sessions would go for like 3 to 4 hours a day. We had to incorporate just her martial art training first, and then do judo, and then at the end of it, try to combine everything all together. We start off with basic stances, basic motion. All martial arts always has a basis, right? It comes from the ground up. So the feet have to be well, and then it works the way up to the knees, to the waist, to the chest, to the head. We segregated the training method. So one day she'd just be working on striking motions with hands. Then the next day we'll recap on throws, but then we'll just focus on just weapon work.
I have a real love and affection for the discipline that goes into martial arts. I was a ballerina for most of my early life, and the discipline around it is very reminiscent to me. I like the hard work. I like being in that gym.
We started off with a simple stick first before we put a axe in her hand to make sure she had her proper lines and she's not, you know, not making sure that
she's
smack anybody with the axe. So we did that first, and then from there we graduated to actually, you know, having the axe with the actual weight and stuff that she was able to strike with it. There's 7 basic effective moves that can be used with the labyrinth. It's a 45-45, following the line, across and cross, and a stab. Those strikes can be modified in all different types of way, but those are the effective basic strikes.
You know, if you stand and you do those moves, fine. It's the fact that you're gonna have to do that 40, 80, 60 times in a day, and then you're looking at the consistency of actually shooting a movie, that's truly where the challenge is.
And that we trained consistently, like every day. We started every other day, but as we got closer to shooting, it was like an everyday process.
It all really fucking hurt.
I'm sure she had a lot of blisters and stuff.
My favorite thing is that when we would be training and I'd be like, so how was that? How was that? And you just walk up to me and be like, yeah, but you're just making it look too hard. And I was like, this shit is hard. Do it again. Yeah. Don't make it look so hard. I was given one of them. I had that thing around me the whole time, even on set. We just always had one around, constantly like practicing motion skills and just feeling like it's like a part of your body. That's what Danny really encouraged. We had to really work on the technique. I think the technique was the hardest thing, and just getting to a place where I could sustain, like where I had enough upper body strength where I could actually fight all day and do those kind of moves over and over and over and over and over again. That axe is such a part of her. We had several, just depending on the scene. We had one that had a little bit more weight to it. We had one that was very real for, like, you know, the closer stuff where we really wanted the closer shots to really feel like it was, we were holding something real. We didn't fight that much with that one just because it is, it's a risk that you just don't want to take. There was like a medium, then there was a really light one that was foamy so that if I had to hit somebody with it, that I could have a really good contact with it, but that it would be soft. But still, you know, at the end of the day, the base of it is a stick. You can't make that soft. So you're still fighting with something that can really hurt somebody. It was a lot. Most of the time, the kind of fighting that I've done in movies has always kind of been motivated by just try and survive. And in this case, that really wasn't the thing in question. It was a skill set that I had to kind of project.
Perfect! Nice!
There wasn't a day that I didn't leave the gym, you know, asking Danny if we could have tequila or vodka that day. And he'd be like, no, Friday, you get to have it.
Friday, always. She had to learn how to use an axe, for sure. She had to learn how to use a saber. She had to learn how to do close combat with hands and feet, and also incorporating weapons.
Gun range, gym. I mean, it sounds very simple when you say like, oh, it was like 3 hours a day, but it became all consuming because outside of the gym, you're either learning, you know, some kind of a weaponry skill, or I was on horseback for many, many hours. There were bigger action sequences that we had on horseback.
She had to just do everything all at once.
I it reminds me so much of just my life as a performer. There's an element of it that is performance-based, and you feel really nervous. Like, I remember us shooting the plane sequence with Andy and Nile. It's a really big set piece for us. It was the first week of shooting, and to start the film off with that, it's just like a lot of nerves, because a lot of this work is kind of done insularly, away from a lot of your department heads, from your director. It really is me and Danny and his team in a space very intimately for a long period of time, but then all of a sudden you're kind of like, you're putting the show up, and that's a little nerve-wracking. Your cameras are rolling, and then when you get it right, it's like there's this level of achievement that you share with so many other people in the film, that it's like a team sport. It's amazing.
Thanks for watching.
And check out The Old Guard on Netflix.